Welcome to the What is EBM section of the EBM Express course. EBM Express is designed to build your understanding of evidence-based practice in short, manageable blocks of content. In this section, we'll be defining EBM and its components and introducing some of its vocabulary. Evidence-based medicine, or EBM, is the integration of best research evidence with clinical expertise and patient values. The concept of evidence-based medicine comes out of work done in the 1970s at McMaster University in Ontario, Canada. Dr. David Sackett, Dr. Brian Haynes, and Dr. Gordon Guyot were among the first to develop and write about this philosophy of medical practice and medical education. The term EBM first appeared in print in 1991 in the ACP Journal Club. As the strength of EBM has become apparent, other healthcare practitioners have developed their own versions, and the philosophy has spread beyond healthcare to other fields. Many people now prefer to use the more general term of evidence-based practice to refer to the concept. From its beginning, EBM has emphasized not just the research evidence, but the physician's clinical experience and training, and the patient's values. EBM must involve all three components. To practice EBM, the clinician finds the evidence and then evaluates the evidence in the context of his or her knowledge and the needs of the individual patient before making a clinical decision. Although EBM consists of three main components, you cannot practice EBM in a vacuum. Therefore, EBM is also influenced by other considerations, such as the organizational context or clinical setting, health insurance policies, available technologies, and many other factors. We'll come back to this idea in other sections of this course. The process of practicing evidence-based medicine includes a 5-stage evidence cycle of assess, ask, acquire, appraise, and apply. The evidence cycle begins with the clinician taking time to assess the clinical situation, incorporating pertinent information to define the clinical problem. The next step in the cycle is ask a clearly stated, answerable question related to the clinical problem. Following the ask is acquire. Using the answerable clinical question, the practitioner acquires the external evidence through searching the medical literature and database resources for appropriate studies. After acquiring the research evidence, the next stage is appraise. The studies you retrieve will attempt to answer the underlying truth of the stated research question. However, they will never exactly represent the real world. Critical appraisal will help identify the flaws of the study, exposing the risk of bias and design errors. Finally, you will use your clinical judgment in determining if the evidence may be applied to your clinical question. As a reminder, the process of EBM is iterative. At any stage, you may find it necessary to revise what you are seeking to best meet the patient's clinical needs or preferences. You may need to go back a step or two to start the cycle over, and this may happen many times. A helpful mnemonic for asking a focused question is the Pico format. Pico stands for patient, population, or problem, intervention, exposure, or prognostic factor, comparison, and outcome of interest. You may also sometimes see the Pico format include additional elements like time or type of study. We will look more closely at Pico in later sections of this course. The EBM pyramid is a popular way of visualizing the amount and hierarchy of medical literature. In the pyramid, the lowest levels represent evidence that is plentiful but not very strong for use in clinical decision making. As we move further up the pyramid, we move into clinical literature types with observational design, which is stronger evidence. Finally, at the very top, we find systematic reviews and meta-analyses, or our secondary literature. This simple pyramid can be very helpful in reminding us what to look for when answering our clinical questions. However, this is not the only EBM pyramid. As with any simple representation of a complex concept, the pyramid continues to evolve, and several different versions have been proposed over the years since its first development. Study types, primary versus secondary literature, and hierarchies of evidence will all be explored in more detail in this course. In this introductory lecture, we've acquainted you with a basic definition of EBM, or evidence-based medicine, and some related terms and concepts. As you move through the course, we'll be looking at these terms and concepts in more depth and giving you an opportunity to practice some EBM skills.